everyone. This time you can watch me try to make a thick resin yoda slice. And to create the crystal effect, I'm going to use 3 self-made silicon druzy molds. So I hope you will enjoy my video and give me a thumbs up for it. So I already started pouring into my silicon cake pan of 24 centimeters. And I'm only going to use 2 colors, white and blue. But the white is opaque and the blue, there you can see it, is transparent. So I'm also going to experiment again with opaque and transparent colors. Yeah, and this will be a thick geode slice because the 2 black druzy molds are about 1.5 centimeters thick. So the slice will be about 2 centimeters thick. And I hope I can create a nice geode tray or decoration tray. And for the resin, I'm using the ArtPro resin from ResinPro. The link to their website is in the description below this video. If you use my code Petra, then you will also get 10% discount if you order from their website. But the information to that is in the description below this video. Yeah, I made those druzy molds myself by growing crystals out of alum salt. I will include a link in the right corner in which I show how I grow those crystals. And I believe you can also use Epsom salt. I never tried it myself, but I heard it from some people that tried it, and yeah, it worked. And I will be working in layers, because I can pour up to 1 centimeter with this resin. So after that I need to let it dry and then I will pour another layer. I'm using my heat gun a lot to remove those air bubbles. And I want to create a white edge, but on top of the thin druzy mold, I want to have some transparent parts, but also the thicker black druzy molds. But yeah, we will see if this turns out nice or not. And for the colors, I'm using a resi tint ink from Eli Chem in the color Marine Blue. And the white is the resi tint Max Titanium White. And I also have a discount code for the Eli Chem supplies to the website resinkunst.de. It's a German website. Unfortunately, they only ship within Europe. But if you use my code Petra10, then you will get 10% discount on your order. So that's great. Again, using my heat gun, and I let those colors blend into each other, or blend together. Again, the titanium white on the edge. Oh no, this is the clear. Because I'm also using clear resin. So I'm almost done with this first layer. I will let this dry and then I will add the second layer, because the black druzy mulch needs to be below the resin. So we are 24 hours later. Now I'm going to pour the second layer. I'm starting again with the titanium white on the edge. There you can see it. And I need to pour that much resin so that the black druzy molds are below my resin. So again, I need to pour at least 1 centimeter thick, using the same colors. And what I also want to do is to create a little bit of that real look of a geode slice. I'm going to add texture onto the edge. But later in this video you can watch how I do that. Some clear. What I also want to mention is that I'm having a Just Paint Cyber Sale. It runs from November 20th to December 1st. And you will get 20% discount if you order through my Etsy shop. And this discount is for all supplies. So mica pigments, chameleon mica pens, silicon druzy molds, glitter flakes, mirrored glass, all supplies, and you will not have to order to a minimum value. It's for my shop, it's for all orders. The same discount for the USA Canada shop, but then you will have to order for a minimum of 50 US dollars, then you will get that 20% discount, and you will get free shipping above 35 US dollars, and that's only for the USA, so not to Canada, but only USA. So if you want to try out my supplies, now you have the chance to get them with a discount. So if you're curious, please check out our Etsy shop. The link to it is in the description below this video. I still need to add some resin because the black druzy inlays or molds are not below the resin yet. So I keep adding clear resin, but also the transparent blue and the opaque white. A little bit more of the white onto the edge. And hopefully this will work. I never tried this before, to add 3 silicon druzy molds in another silicon mold. So hopefully this will turn out okay. A little bit of darker shade of blue, still transparent. Some clear. and my heat gun again. I never use a torch because the flame of the torch is very hot, and if you use it, then you have a risk that the resin will stick to the silicon. And the other side will be the side that I will be using. That's my intention. So not this side, but the other side. Because there is the druzy crystal effect. So I'm almost done. I will let this dry and then I will show you all how I remove the druzy inlay molds. So the resin is dry. First I need to take my geode slice out of the silicon cake pan. No problem there. Also, this side looks nice, but it's my intention to use it on the other side. Here you can see it. A lot of white on the edge. That's what I was expecting, because I used a lot of white. Now I'm trying to remove my three druzy molds. I'm starting with the black molds. And hopefully I have some nice transparent parts. First one is out. Looks nice. At the end of this video, I'm going to show you a close-up. Then you can see the druzy crystal effect much better. And now the thinner druzy inlay molds. This mold is about 16 by 18 centimeters. And it's really thin. Yeah, it's a little bit stuck underneath the resin, so I'm going to use my heat gun, very careful, to make the resin more soft so that I can remove my silicon mold much easier. And it looks nice. Some nice transparent parts. Now I need to remove the parts that are loose. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. Because that's not nice. Again, heating it a little bit, make the resin more soft. And normally then you can remove those parts very easy. There you can see it. But I'm pleased how it looks. Cutting away those parts. And this takes a little bit of time. But you can already see the sparkle. So I'm almost done, and then I will show you how I add some texture onto the edge of this geode slice. And to create that structure onto my edge, I'm using ResiCrete, and it's a two-component structure paste, and you can make it as thin or as thick as you want. And it's a kind of a powder with a polymer medium, and I'm going to use three colors. This color is the sky blue. But if you have white ResiCrete, you can also color it yourself with an acrylic ink or paint. But this one already has or had the color. But I want to try to create a little bit of that a real stone. With that crystal druzy effect in the middle. So we are a little bit further in the process. There you can see I'm using white also on top of my geode slice, and then I'm blending the colors. So this will be a decoration plate, so you can't use it, I think. I think you can't use it. I think you need to place it on a stand so that the light will shine through. I think that will look amazing. So all the way around, I'm adding that white ResiCrete on the edge. Again, a little bit further. This is another color. This is the turquoise color. Very nice. So this powder needs to have a binder, and I've used Vallejo polymer medium, because then it will stick together, and then you can make a paste, kind of a paste out of it. Yeah, now I made it thinner to let it drip over the sides. I can see it. More of the sky blue color. Because I want to have that rough look. All the supplies I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box below this video. And I always add the link to the website, so if you're curious, please check out the description. There's a lot of information there. Now I'm using my palette knife to create some texture. Blending the colors together. Now you can see it. So I will not add resin onto the edge. I will leave it as is because I like that shiny against the rough texture of the edge of the resicrete. So I'm almost done. I will let this dry and then I will show you all the end result. So this is the end result. I have it outside in the daylight. There you can see the nice structure of the resicrete with the three different colors and the really amazing crystal effect. I like it a lot. It sparkles. Very nice. And there you can see the holes I made with the two black druzy molds. Yeah, really nice. Let me know what you think of my geode slice. And this is how it looks with light behind it. Also very nice. It almost looks like it glows. So let me know what you think. Consider to subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. All the information to my promo code or my cyber sale to my Etsy shop. The link is in the description box below this video. And a lot more information in the description. So I want to thank you all for watching again. And hopefully I will see you all in the next video. Bye.